Hi students, in this video we are going to see the gastrointestinal system development. It's also very interesting. Look at this. This is called, only initially you will be having one tube called as gut tube. The gut tube will be having, it is present in the middle of the abdominal cavity. So anteriorly you have a hole called as ventral mesentery, and posteriorly you have a hole called as dorsal mesentery. The anterior ventral mesentery or mesogastrium, inside that there is a development of the liver. So liver bud will go inside, and it forms a liver here. So the liver divides the ventral mesogastrium into two portions. The one which is anterior to the liver and to the anterior abdominal wall is falciform ligament, and the posterior portion of the ventral mesogastrium between the liver and the stomach, the developing stomach, is called as lesser omentum. So these two are the derivatives of ventral mesogastrium, and the student should know that ventral mesogastrium is, ventral mesentery is derived from the septum transversum. Usually students think that septum transversum gives rise to the central tendon of diaphragm. So you should think septum transversum gives rise to diaphragm, not only to the central tendon of the diaphragm but also to the ventral mesentery. The next one is, this is called as dorsal mesentery. This is ventral in the front, and this is called as dorsal mesentery towards the posterior abdominal wall. So dorsal mesentery, you will be having one important organ it's getting developed, and that is your spleen. And then the stomach rotation starts. Okay, here from the liver there is a inferior part of the falciform ligament, there is a fold coming out here that is called as that obliterated left umbilical vein. It is called as ligamentum teres hepatis. And the next is, the stomach starts its rotation, 90-degree clockwise rotation. Stomach is 90-degree clockwise rotation. This right ventral portion, it will be turned towards the right, and the dorsal portion is turned towards the left. So the ventral is called as, this border is called as lesser curvature, and this border is called as greater curvature. This greater curvature starts expanding. Look at this. After the rotation, still it is there in the middle axis. Okay, longitudinal axis. Longitudinal rotation, the right ventral border goes towards the right, dorsal border goes towards the left, and this is clockwise rotation, and it is lesser curvature and it's greater curvature. The greater curvature starts enlarging, and then the anteroposterior rotation takes place. Because this cardiac end goes towards the left and the pyloric end goes towards the right. Look at this. This is the greater curvature getting enlarged. Because of this, you have the anteroposterior rotation. Initially, longitudinal rotation 90 degree. This is anteroposterior rotation. This is how the stomach rotates. And the next goes to the midgut. So you should know the foregut derivatives. So the derivatives of foregut are esophagus lower end and the stomach, liver bud, so liver, cystic bud, gallbladder, lung bud, lung. So everything is derived from the foregut only. Next, the midgut. Midgut is not able to accommodate the entire intestinal loop inside the abdominal cavity in the fetal life, sixth week of intrauterine life. So at the sixth week of intrauterine life, because of the growth of the liver, this intestine loops will be thrown out. Here the midgut artery is superior mesenteric artery. It forms an axis. So all these loops are coming out. It is called as physiological herniation. It occurs at sixth week of intrauterine life. And here you will be having, the midgut is connected to the umbilicus by a duct called vitelloindestinal duct. And here this is the pre-arterial segment, or this is artery. So above the artery it is called as pre-arterial segment. Below the artery it is called as post-arterial segment. So here you can see the cecal bud in the post-arterial or caudal limb of the loop. This is called cranial limb. Cecal bud will be giving rise to cecum and the appendix. And here all the intestinal loops is getting enlarged, okay, and coiled. So when it comes out, it takes 90 degree rotation and it is counterclockwise. And when it is going back at the 10th week, the body wall is getting enlarged. So you have enough cavity, enough space inside the abdominal cavity. So at 10th week, these loops will be going inside. When it goes inside, again it takes 180 degree rotation, counterclockwise rotation. So when it comes out 90 degree, when it goes back 180 degree, totally 270 degree rotation. So all your intestinal loops below the artery, everything will be going into the abdominal cavity, and they all settle into the left part of the abdominal cavity. So the cecal bud goes towards the right portion of the abdominal cavity, just below the liver. The last part of the rotation, the cecal bud comes down to the right iliac fossa. This is how the rotation occurs. Everything goes below the superior mesenteric vessel. So you just go and see the cadaver, all your loops will be placed below the artery. Right? So this is the last rotation. Sometimes this stage 4 rotation will not happen and descent will not happen. So some people, they will be having their cecum and appendix near the liver. So it is called a subhepatic cecum. Look at this last stage of rotation. It has come down nicely. You have colon as nicely it is there. So, and the next one is, I said there is a connection existing between the midgut. Usually this connection disappears. If it persists, it is called as vitelo-intestinal duct. And only it persists, protruded as a pouch, the distal portion disappears. Only the proximal portion, it forms a diverticulum. It is called as Meckel's diverticulum. Only in 2% of the individuals, you will be getting the Meckel's diverticulum. And 2 feet away from the ileocecal junction. This is the junction, ileocecal junction. 2 feet away from the ileocecal junction, 2 centimeters in length, and it may contain gastric mucosa or pancreatic mucosa. If it contains this mucosa, sometimes it may lead for hemorrhage. Okay, so this is a applied aspect you can write for midgut rotation and vitelo-intestinal duct, Meckel's diverticulum. Sometimes, see, the proximal portion is opened and the distal portion obliterates. It is forming the sinus and both the portions are connected. It is called as fistula, and then both sides it is obliterated, and only in the middle there is a collection of fluid that is called cyst. So these are the complications of Meckel's diverticulum, and these are the derivatives. Here I have typed everything. What are the structures arising from the foregut, and what are the structures arising from the midgut, and what are the things coming from the hindgut. So as a student, you should know hindgut is the last portion that we will see in the endodermal cloaca. That left 1/3 to the anal canal, everything is derived from the hindgut. So students should know foregut stops at the second part of the duodenum above the opening of the bile duct. From the opening of the bile duct to the right 2/3 of the transverse colon, it is midgut. And the foregut is left to 1/3 of the transverse colon to the anal canal. It's derived from the hindgut. And here the rotation law I have told. If the loops fail to go back inside at the 10th week of intrauterine life, it is called as omphalocele. All the loops will be placed outside into the abdominal cavity, and it is covered by the amnion. This is called as, it is covered by amnion, so it is called as omphalocele. If it is doesn't covered by the amnion and it is not coming out through the umbilical opening, it is called as gastroschisis. Usually this physiological herniation doesn't go back no 10th week, that is called as omphalocele. It comes out through the umbilical opening. This is because of the body wall defect just parallel to the umbilicus, mainly onto the right side. If the loops are thrown outside, it is not covered by amnion. Look at the difference. It is covered by amnion, it is not covered by amnion. This is called gastroschisis, and that is called omphalocele. Omphalocele, other anomalies will also be associated with this. So baby will die. Here it is not associated with any chromosomal abnormality. So look at the questions. Which of the following structure does not develop in the mesentery of the stomach? I said liver is developing in the ventral mesentery, and the spleen develops in the dorsal mesentery. Pancreas also is a derivative of the foregut. Okay, it is also present there. But kidney, I have never told anything about the kidney. So kidney is not the development of this. And then gastrosplenic ligament contains. Gastrosplenic, it means related to spleen and the gastro. So from the spleen, you have the artery comes towards the stomach is short gastric arteries. And this is only one thing is asked. So what is that? Short gastric artery is the answer. So from the spleen, something is coming towards the stomach is only short gastric artery. Rest splenic vessel, tail of the pancreas and all, it is present in the lean urinary ligament. Ligaments contain splenic artery. Splenic artery means definitely it should be there in the splenorenal ligament. Lenorenal ligament is the answer. Okay, spleen develops from, very easy question. Liver develops from ventral, spleen develops from dorsal mesogastrium. And the next is part of the colon with no mesentery. Everywhere you have the mesentery except in the rectum, you don't have the mesentery. And ventral mesogastrium derivatives include all except, I said falciform ligament is anterior to the liver, and behind the liver to the stomach it is lesser omentum, and the coronary ligament is a derivative of the falciform ligament. So gastrosplenic is not there. Okay, which of the following structure develop in the ventral part of the mesentery of the stomach? That is your ventral part of the ventral mesentery. Ventral mesentery of the stomach is your lesser omentum. During development of the spleen, lobulation is seen to the in which border? Superior border. And then physiological hernia reduces at which month? I said 10th week or 11th week. It means 1/4 are 4, 2/4 are 8, 3/4 are 12. So it is around 3rd month. Meckel's diverticulum is a remnant of vitello intestinal duct. Okay. Next, which is not associated with vitello intestinal duct? Ileal diverticulum, mesenteric cyst, umbilical sinus is there, enterocystoma is there, and mesenteric cyst is not there. Regarding Meckel's diverticulum, all are true except very important question. It is always present in the anteromesenteric border. It is a remnant of vitello intestinal duct, and it is 2 inches long, and it has, since it is related to the umbilicus, it looks like appendicitis, pain at the umbilicus. It is 2 inches long, not 3 inches long. And these are the questions. Answers you can find out. So much is there, but less time. So derivatives of midgut I have already given. Ventral mesogastrium derivatives also we have given. Rectum develops from which gut? Obviously hindgut. And then all develop from the endodermal cloaca, except endodermal cloaca and bladder will be seen in the next video. So after seeing that video, you can give the answers for all these questions, inner membrane, everything. Here you can add all of them develop in mesentery of the stomach except liver is there, spleen is there, pancreas is there, except kidney. Repeated question. Okay. And which of the following is the duodenum derived? Obviously, it is derived from the second part of the duodenum, that after the rotation you have that. So second part of the, which part duodenum is derived? The first part is derived from the foregut, second part is derived from the midgut. So you should write both foregut and midgut. And then cloaca, next topic. And the pancreas and all we'll see. Ligament arteries of liver is the remnant of obliterated left umbilical vein. Few questions. Omphaloenteric duct or vitellointestinal duct is Meckel's diverticulum. Duodenum is derived from both foregut and midgut. True regarding Meckel's diverticulum, it is present in which border? Not mesenteric. It is present in the anti-mesenteric border. All three well is. So only one is true. That is presence commonly in the lower abdominal pain. No. Second common is congenital anomaly of the all three layers of the gut wall are present. Descending colon is supplied by, descending colon means fourth part. So it is derived from the hindgut. So hindgut artery is inferior mesenteric artery. Hirschsprung's disease is, next we'll be saying congenital megacolon, that I will discuss in the next video. Medial umbilical, this and all next video. So if you have Meckel's diverticulum is a remnant of vitellointestinal duct. That's all. Most common site of ectopic pancreatic tissue is in the midgut loop only. You'll be having ectopic pancreatic tissue, jejunum, the diverticulum. So that's all. If you have any queries, ask me in the comment box. Thank you.